ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. The biggest gathering for Muslims in Hajj, especially the day of Arafah. All the people who are doing Hajj should be in Arafah that day. Maybe in Tawaf, they'll do Tawaf on the 10th day, 11th day. In Muzdalifah, some people go late. But in Arafah, all people in Hajj prepare to stay in Arafah, to listen to the khutbah. I'll mention, inshallah, some points from the Hajj of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he did, or he said, in this biggest gathering for the Muslim Ummah, about 3 millions, or maybe sometimes 4 millions, Allahu A'lam, even more maybe. He emphasized some points by his sayings or his actions in the Hajj, and especially in Arafah, Arafah Day. One of these points, he declared the Tawheed sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in front of the Muslim Ummah. When he started the Hajj, he started with Tawheed. As Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated the hadith, the long hadith describing the Hajj of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the 10th year. He said there were a lot of people in front of him, on his right, on his left, from his back, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, riding, walking. When he started the Hajj, فَأَهَلَّ بِالتَّوْحِيدِ. He started with Tawheed, oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he continued to say this until throwing the jamarat, throwing the stones in Mina. He was saying, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the word of Tawheed, لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك، إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. This is the sentence of Tawheed. Not like the mushriks. They used to say this sentence and they add إلا شريكا هو لك، ملكته وما ملك. They say in their talbiyah, in Hajj, in Umrah, the same thing, but they add لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك، no partner with you. Then they say except a partner. That partner you own him, but he doesn't own. Subhanallah. What is the benefit of a partner who doesn't own, who cannot do anything? But this is shirk. So this is one of the main points in the Hajj. The Prophet ﷺ was emphasizing the Tawheed. Another point in Hajj, the Prophet ﷺ emphasized this by his action, which is مُخَالَفَةِ المشركين, opposing the mushriks. This is one of the main concepts in Islam. As the Prophet ﷺ said, خَالِفُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. The Prophet ﷺ said, act against the mushrikeen, oppose them, don't imitate them. You are Muslim, you are muwahid, you are the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should not be like them. How? In Hajj, during the day of Arafah, the mushriks create something from themselves, not from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that people who called al-Hums, al-Hums people of Quraysh, they have special place in the day of Arafah. So after Mina, in the night day, in the morning, between Dhuhr and sunrise, the Muslim should go from Mina to Arafah. But the mushriks used to stay in the Haram area because we are from Quraysh. So they were expecting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to stay in the Haram area, not in Arafah. And Arafah is not part of the Haram area. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam opposed them. And he went to Arafah to be in the place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him. And also at the day of Muzdalifah, or the day after Muzdalifah, how he left, or when he left Muzdalifah, as you know, after Arafah, the Muslims go to Muzdalifah. They should sleep there in Muzdalifah. And after Fajr prayer, they leave Muzdalifah to Mina, or to do Tawaf. The mushriks used to leave Muzdalifah after the sunrise. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left Muzdalifah before the sunrise to tell them, I'm not like you. We are Muslims. We are slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a very concept, very important concept to oppose the kuffar, the mushrikeen. And there are many things in his life, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even in combing the hair. Even there's something simple. The mushrik used to leave the hair on the forehead, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was combing the hair to the left or right side, to the right or left side. He did not like to keep his hair like the mushriks. Like this. And everything he can do, opposite of them, he will do. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, one of the points in Hajj, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was emphasizing that there is no difficulty in Islam. Islam is the religion of mercy. A man came asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Oh Rasulullah, I slaughtered my sheep before, I shaved my hair before slaughtering the sheep." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Do, and there is no harm." Another person said, "Oh Rasulullah, I slaughtered the sheep before throwing the stone." The Prophet ﷺ said, "Do and there is no harm. If'al wala haraj." What is the meaning of this? Islam is the religion of ease, mercy. No difficulty in Islam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَجَاهِدُوا فِي اللَّهِ حَقَّ جِهَادِهِ هُوَ جِتَبَاكُمْ وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجْ مِلَّةَ أَبِيكُمْ إِبْرَاهِيمِ. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, so subhanahu wa ta'ala, and strive for Allah with the striving due to Him. He has chosen you and has not placed upon you in the religion any difficulty. If you are in any difficulty, Islam will make it easy for you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent the Sahaba to give da'wah in different areas. And he was commanding them, يَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا. يَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا. Yeah, make the things easy, not difficult. This is very important concept in Islam. And it was clear in the Hajj of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, one of the important concept in Hajj, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did, to be soft with your brothers and sisters. الرفق والسكينة. You know the number of Muslims in Hajj. When he left Arafah to Muzdalifah, of course, imagine this, and of course, many of you did Hajj, and they lived in these moments. When we leave Arafah to Muzdalifah, subhanallah, it is as the day of judgment, Allah al-Musta'an. So many people like to find a place in Muzdalifah. So as a human nature, everyone wants to to become before his brother. But the Prophet ﷺ was saying to the Muslim, As-sakina, as-sakina, slow down, slow down. And also he was trying to control his she-camel, not to go fast. And this is very important in Islam. To be soft with your brothers and sisters, even in the salah. Even in the salah, when we stand up in the jama'ah, what he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلِينُوا بَأَيْدِي إِخْوَانِكُمْ. Be soft. Don't push him by your elbow, your shoulder. This is not part of Sharia. So, to be soft with your brothers, have mercy with your brothers, this is part of our Sharia. Also, one of the main concepts we can learn from Hajj of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially in Arafah, as I mentioned, dua and dhikr. Dua and dhikr. Why we do Hajj? Wallahi, to come back, then I put in my name Hajji. This is haram. You want to show people that I did Hajj? Hajj to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua. If you notice the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in these days in Hajj, most of his time, dhikr and dua. Dhikr and dua. Not from the time of Hajj, even before Hajj. Before starting the Ihram, he used to say dhikr, la ilaha illallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these kinds of dhikr, before giving Ihram. And after saying the Ihram, after saying labbayka hajjan or labbayka umrah, he started what? Labbayka Allahumma labbayka, labbayka la sharika laka labbayka, innal hamda wal ni'mata laka wal mulk. La sharika lak, repeating this statement, great statement. And during the tawaf, dhikr. In Safa, also on the Marwa, dua and dhikr. During the day of Arafah, after the Maghrib, after the Dhuhr and Asr prayer, until Maghrib, how many hours? We finish Dhuhr and Asr, if you are combining the Salah in Arafah, let's say 12:30 or 1. So from 1 until 6:30, at least 5-6 hours. For what? Dua. The Prophet ﷺ was standing, raising his hands, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also in Muzdalifah, after he prayed al-Fajr, he was giving dua, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After throwing the stones, also he did dua, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So dhikr and dua in Hajj and Umrah. So this is the life of the Muslim. When you go there, try your best to make dhikr and dua. Train yourself from now. Yes, in that place, subhanAllah, you meet many people there. And you like to sit and chat with them. But don't make the shaitan drag you to waste your time and some time backbiting, doing haram things and saying haram things. Stop your shaitan and make dhikr and follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا اسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد. One of the important points in Hajj of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, before going to Mina to throw the stones رمي جمرة العقبة in the 10th day, which is the Eid day, he told الفضل ابن العباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما, هات القطي الحصى, please give me the pebbles, the small stones to throw the jamara. So al-Fadl ibn Abbas brought small stones, okay. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم looked at them, seven stones, and he showed the people, they are small. Yani the diameter about 1 centimeter, something like this. Then he showed the people and he said, like these stones use. Amtal ha'ula farmu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, like these. And use like this size. And beware of going too extremes in religious matter, even in throwing the stones, and also in everything in your life. Don't exceed the limit. Don't be extreme. In your salah, in your fasting, reciting Quran, even in giving charity. Yes, even giving charity. The Prophet ﷺ did not die to give all of your money. When Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas said, "Oh Rasulullah, I want to give my money as charity," the Prophet ﷺ said, "Not allow this." He said, "Oh Rasulullah, two-thirds? No. Half? No." Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas wants to give half of his wealth as a charity. The Prophet ﷺ told him, "No." Even in giving charity, it is not allowed to become extreme. Then Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas said, "Okay, oh Rasulullah, one-third." The Prophet ﷺ said, "Okay, one-third, and one-third of your wealth is too much. But this is allowed." Yani. So this is an important concept in Sharia. When you are talking about a person, it is not allowed to praise him more than enough. Even the Prophet ﷺ, Muhammad ﷺ, when they came to him and they mentioned some point, they said something to him. "You are our master, you are the best among us." The Prophet ﷺ said, "Qulu biqawlikum ba'daqakum." Be careful. Be careful. "Innama ana abd." I am a slave. I am only a slave, I am not a lord. I don't know the unseen. I don't know the future. I don't have anything. "Innama ana abd." So what you should say? "Qulu abdullah wa rasulah." Messenger of Allah, the slave of Allah. Why? Because he doesn't want us to become like the Christians who said Isa is the son of Allah or Thalatha, one of the three. How they reach to this point? Step by the shaitan. By following the extremes. So this is one of the main concepts in Hajj. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us and teach the Muslims in that place. Last point. He gave a strong khutbah in the day of Arafah and in front of all Muslims. And one of these points, very important, and all of them important, verily, your blood, your property are as sacred and inviolable as the sacredness of this day of yours, in the month of yours, in this town of yours. Haram area, haram day, and haram month. So your blood, and also your wealth, your money, your property. It means it is haram to steal the money of your brother. Or to cheat him. Also to kill him, to beat him. This is haram, not allowed in Sharia. What is going on in the Muslim Ummah now? This is forbidden. Even among the students in the class, or the friends, or sometimes in the street, because of ridiculous thing, they fight. This is haram. Spill your blood, his blood. This is haram. As the Prophet ﷺ declared clearly on the day of Arafah. Brothers and sisters, if we follow the regulations of Rasulullah ﷺ, we'll live in peace. And we'll be strong ummah. Why we are weak? Because we are not following our messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minin wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareeb mujib ad da'wat ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adhaban nar. Allahumma ij'al hadha